Oh, good afternoon. This is not going to be a long ceremony, but it's going to be a nice one. And there are a lot of people to thank, and I really appreciate this wonderful crowd for coming here. I see so many people who've been involved in this process over the years, and it's just gratifying to see everybody come back here again to be here as we open the station. It's hard to believe that it was almost exactly this same time last year, December 11th to be precise, that we assembled on this very spot to welcome the return of passenger rail service to Southampton Roads. After going without passenger service for 35 years, it certainly was an achievement to celebrate. And just as last year, we are honored to be joined by a number of friends whose combined efforts were responsible for restoring passenger service to the most populous portion of southeastern Virginia. From the city council, we have Councilman Barkley Wynn, we have the Vice Mayor Anthony Burford, Councilman Tommy Smeagol, we have Councilwoman Angela Williams. From the General Assembly, we have Senator Kenny Alexander. I see Delegate Dawn Hester here. I know Senator Frank Wagner said he was going to make it. I know he's trying, but maybe we'll see him in a minute. I want to thank all of them for being here. We are especially honored to have the Director of Rail and Public Transportation and Norfolk native Thelma Drake with us. Thelma played an absolutely vital role in bringing passenger rail back to Norfolk. Working with Amtrak officials, Norfolk Southern, and CSX Railroads, and with the General Assembly and the Governor to secure $100 million in funding that made passenger rail service possible. So thank you, Thelma, for all you have done and all you continue to do for us. Governor Bob McDonnell was unable to be with us today, but I certainly want to acknowledge the support he gave to passenger rail for Southampton Roads. I would also acknowledge the signature achievement of his administration, the first statewide transportation funding package in a generation. The legislation passed the General Assembly with bipartisan support and will provide $3.5 billion in statewide funding over the next 5 years. $1 billion of which will go towards much needed and long delayed transportation projects here in our region. This is an enormously important contribution to the region's and the state's economic future, and we certainly want to thank Governor McDonnell for his leadership in this regard. And I'd like to welcome our new Secretary of Transportation, Secretary Designate, if you will, Aubrey Lane. Aubrey, where'd you go, Aubrey? There you are. Thank you for being here. Aubrey, thanks for coming out today, and we look forward to working with you on rail and other important transportation priorities for Hampton Roads over the next 4 years at least. We're also pleased to have a number of other folks who are with us today. I don't know how to actually say, I mean, get to everybody, but I would like to acknowledge the presence of Jim Hickson from Norfolk Southern, who is important in making this happen, as well as Mark Honecker. We have Kevin Page, the Chief Operating Officer of Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation, one of the heroes who were the boots on the ground. Kevin made this thing work. Kevin, where are you? A special thanks to you, Kevin, for all that you have done. Thank you. We have Don Skinner from Amtrak. I didn't see Rodney, but I heard he was going to try to get here from the Port Authority. Dwight Farmer from the Hampton Roads Transportation Planning Organization. Art Moy from the Virginia Maritime Association. We have a number of representatives here from the business community, and that would include from the Chamber of Commerce, from the Greater Norfolk Corporation, from the Downtown Norfolk Council, Virginia Economic Development Authority. We have groups, folks here from the Hampton Roads Transportation's, Hampton Roads Public Transportation Alliance. Robin, where are you, by the way? My first memory of this odyssey where we went on trying to bring rail here is Robin with the whistle blowing this crowd into Nauticus, into the cruise terminal. Robin, I still remember that. The meeting was packed. Thelma used that picture all over the state to get you know, to get support for us. So I want to thank everybody for coming out. I know I missed a lot of folks, but forgive me for that. But Hollis Ellis from the Commonwealth Transportation Board is here. Matthew James from the General Assembly. I could stop right now, I guess. I'm sorry, Matthew. But and the city manager, Marcus Jones, is here as well. So thanks to all of you and for everything that you did. Harbor Park is known by all as the home of the Norfolk Tides baseball team. But for many years, this same area was known as the hub for railway operations in Norfolk. Its history dates back more than 150 years to 1856, when the Norfolk and Petersburg Railroad, a company founded by VMI graduate William Mahone, purchased the surrounding property, which at the time was called Brambles Point. From here, tracks were laid down Water Street to the west, giving trains direct access to the wharves and the docks that lined the waterfront all the way to Town Point Park. Norfolk's last passenger rail station on this site was Union Station, which opened in 1912. And that was about a good baseball's throw away from us, just across the parking lot. As rail travel declined in the years following World War II, Union Station was closed in 1962, and it was demolished the following year. 50 years after its demolition, we meet here again, this time to cut the ribbon on a new passenger station that will serve as a destination and a landmark for riders departing Norfolk for Washington, New York, and points north, and visitors arriving here from those same destinations. A passenger station was the one piece missing from last year's celebration, and for good reasons. Our partners, the Commonwealth, Norfolk Southern, CSX, and Amtrak, worked so efficiently and so well together that rail service was able to begin almost a year ahead of schedule, and before we had a chance to design and build a passenger station. Who would have believed that? The facility we opened today is a $3.75 million investment by the city that will serve residents from across the region. Included within its modern architecture is a spacious lounge where passengers can wait for the train in comfort, along with other amenities designed to enhance the passenger's experience. The building was also designed with an eye to the future and can be easily expanded as that becomes necessary. With the Harbor Park Light Rail Station, regular HRT bus service, ferry service, and now a train passenger terminal, the long-held vision of establishing a major intermodal regional transportation hub in downtown has been achieved. And as we look ahead, the future for passenger rail is bright. As more and more people discover the convenience of train travel, as improvements to tracks and alignments allow for higher speeds, and as work on high-speed rail advances, riding the train will become as popular as airline travel. And with the return of passenger rail service, and with this new station, Norfolk and Southampton Roads is now a part of that future. And now I am pleased to introduce our next speaker, Director of Rail and Public Transportation, and former Congresswoman Thelma Drake. And as I noted a few moments ago, Thelma's efforts were essential to securing passenger rail service and as a way to officially recognize her contributions. The City Council has a special proclamation prepared to present to her. And so Thelma, if you will come up. Okay, there's a lot to say here. I'm going to try to get through it, Thelma. It reads, whereas Thelma D. Drake currently serves as Director of Virginia's Department of Rail and Public Transportation for the Commonwealth and also previously represented the City of Norfolk effectively in both the House of Delegates and the United States House of Representatives, and whereas prior to Amtrak restoring direct service to Norfolk in December of 2012, Southside Hampton Roads was without an intercity passenger rail connection for 3.5 decades. After the final train pulled out of Norfolk in 1977. Whereas intercity passenger rail services are a major regional asset, helping to attract travel and investment by offering businesses, residents, and tourists a safe, comfortable, and convenient transportation option, and ridership totals for the Norfolk train over the past year clearly demonstrate the great regional need and desire for this long-missing transportation connection. Whereas restoration of Amtrak service to Norfolk was achieved through an effective partnership involving Director Drake and the Commonwealth of Virginia, Amtrak, Norfolk Southern, CSX, and the City of Norfolk all working together to advance needed phases of the project. Whereas Director Drake's strong, tenacious, and unwavering commitment to bringing rail service back to Norfolk was essential at every step of the process, up to and including helping to secure more than $100 million in funding to make the vision a reality. Whereas Director Drake was also instrumental in leading and protecting the initial design and construction of the Norfolk station platform and service facility so they will accommodate the future growth of service without the additional expense, local infrastructure investment, or disruption of service. Whereas Director Drake's dedication to passenger rail service to Norfolk has continued beyond last year's opening through her work to help secure an ongoing state rail fund supporting inner city train operations in Virginia, and also to advance consideration with Amtrak on the possibility of bringing additional daily trains to Norfolk and on the fastest possible time schedule. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that I, Paul Frame, Mayor of the City of Norfolk, on behalf of City Council and the citizens of Norfolk, do hereby extend sincere thanks and appreciation to Thelma Drake for the outstanding leadership and support she provided in restoring essential intercity passenger rail to Norfolk, given under my hand the second day of December 2013. Thelma, thank you so much.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can set that down.
I'll put it right
okay.
there.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Mayor Frame, and good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for being here on this beautiful sunny day for another great celebration in the city of Norfolk. The mayor's correct. We told him it would be 4 years before train service started, and actually next month it will be 4 years since Norfolk Southern stood up, many of you were there, in a public meeting and said they'd like to work with the Commonwealth to start intercity passenger rail to Norfolk, as the mayor said, the first time since 1977. And we took that seriously, we grabbed it, we ran with great partners, Norfolk Southern, CSX, the City of Norfolk. All of them got constant phone calls saying, this is what we need and this is how we need it done. And every single one of them said yes. And that's why it happened within 3 years' time. And that we're standing here a year later. I think we just wanted an extra celebration, Mayor, that we would come today to dedicate. And a beautiful building that reminds you of what train stations look like. All the glass, what a great way to welcome visitors to the city of Norfolk with this beautiful station. So thank you to the city of Norfolk. And what was historic as well about this service is that part of the funding that the mayor talked about built a connection track so that in the Petersburg area we can go north. And we didn't have that ability in the past before now. And that we can go into the Amtrak Northeast Corridor and go as far as Boston, same seat, right out of little tiny Norfolk. So we do, not little tiny anymore, Mayor, I'm sorry, but we are continuing to work for the future, as the mayor said. As you know, we've gotten a little bit later departure, the 5 a.m. departure. We'll continue to work on, can we get it even slightly later? But what's been very exciting to watch is that people are using the Amtrak bus. And if you go to Amtrak.com, you're gonna see three departures from the city of Norfolk because two use the bus to go to Newport News. So leisure travelers are saying, I don't wanna leave that early in the morning, but I wanna come back to Norfolk. And business travelers are saying, yes, I do wanna leave that early in the morning. And then I wanna come back later at night, so I'll come into the city of Newport News. So even though we only have one departure, and it is very early departure, in May of this year, Norfolk hit the expectations that Amtrak had for this train. And more importantly, in August of this year, you started putting money in the bank. So that's a great accomplishment for the city. Now, here we are, great accomplishment. We're making money on the train, and of course, the federal government changed all the rules October 1. So we don't have that bill yet, but as you know, and the mayor referenced the transportation bill, historic transportation bill. Thank you to the governor, to the secretary, to Secretary Connaughton, to all of the members of the General Assembly, and to each and every one of you that worked so hard to see that bill passed. But for the first time ever, we have dedicated funding for inner-city passenger rail. We didn't have that when this train came up. We had to go to the assembly and get their permission to use other funds to bring up this service. And that'll be money for operating and money for capital. And many people didn't realize that the law that was passed by Congress in 2008, if we had not secured dedicated funding to run our Virginia trains, they would have stopped October 1. Not just Lynchburg and Norfolk, but our two Newport News and our two Richmonds as well. So we're excited that things are moving forward so well. We want to thank you for your support, your ridership. Tell everybody how wonderful it is to ride the train, how comfortable it is, how wide the seats are, that there's a cafe car. I saw Leo Wardrop the other day and he said, there's a cafe car? Yes, there's a cafe car. So it makes a difference. And I've also had FHWA come to me and say, I think you're using the congestion on 95 to market that train. To which I said, absolutely. I don't know if you've seen our billboards, but that's what it is. Traffic and a train that's moving. So thank you. We look forward to new service coming. We continue to work on that and to see when we can get trains 2 and 3 into Norfolk. So that's just an ongoing work with our railroads right now. So thank you. And I know you all look forward to being inside and seeing how beautiful it is. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, because the city of Norfolk really did everything that we asked them to do. So thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I was right. Senator Wagner did make it. Frank, thank you for being here. And I've been looking around. I thought I saw my wife in the crowd. Beth, are you here? Where are you? There you are. Okay, all right. Well, thank you for coming as well. Can I get the members for the City Council and the General Assembly to come on up as we cut the ribbon?
Come on in.